until the day with the dawn ringing in my ears. Oh, well, I tune to my TV show. No better way, I gotta get myself into gear. Let's go. Oh, and I feel good today with my wake up in the morning espresso. I feel good today. It's my feel good breakfast show.
Well, a very good morning, Sabanan Dumelang Bahayat. Welcome to your Feel Good Breakfast Show Expresso on SABC3, live, large, and in charge. Getting amongst your mornings, into your bed, get out. Here's your coffee. How are you doing?
How's it going?
That was pretty cool.
Imagine you just like literally did that.
Like karate out of bed.
Just karate out of bed.
I know there is at least one person out there who does wake up to this show. So thank you so much for doing that. And we're going to reward you this morning with an unbelievable lineup. We love the power of sport, what it can do in within communities. We're using it to fight crime this morning, but also to give fans, super fans like myself, the opportunity to play against some of their favorite footballing stars. We've got Nathan Paulse and Eleazar Rodgers in the house this morning. We're going to talk about their seasons and this golden opportunity. But what an awesome initiative.
Absolutely. We're also checking out some of the movies that are opening up this weekend with JP Sebastian.
Very nice. And then I can't believe that there are any cast members left of Game of Thrones, but a new season is upon us. Winter is coming. Yes, finally it is here. But we're going to see the cast in a very different light, performing a song that is quite ironic.
Yeah, and then the king of African rap, Questa himself, is going to be performing for you today. Man, the guy is, I mean, he's just like...
He's on top.
He is the Game of Thrones throne person. He is sitting on the throne that is the Game of the Music throne.
He's not
game.
Going anywhere. That's
he is
nice
the game.
Thing.
He is the throne.
He is the game. There we go. Well, it's going to be a fantastic morning. Let's get it underway. Let's take a look at our temperatures in the cities.
Well, let's get your morning underway and a very good morning to you. And it seems like most parts of the country can't expect icy cold temperatures today, with partly cloudy to sunny conditions expected elsewhere. In Polokwane, a low of 5 with a high of 20. Mbombela, 9, reaching a high of 22. Pretoria, 6, 21. Johannesburg, 5, with a high of 20. Mahikeng expects sunshine with a low of 6 and a high of 24. Klerksdorp, 4, with a high of 23. Kimberley 4:20, Bloemfontein -2, reaching a high of 20. Richards Bay 15:22, Pietermaritzburg 7 with a high of 20. Durban today 15, reaching a high of 21. Mthatha 5 with a high of 20. East London 12:21, Cradock 5 with a high of 20. Port Elizabeth today a low of 10 and a high of 20 expected. George 8:18, Sutherland partly cloudy, a low of 1 and a high of 13. Cape Town 12, reaching a cool 15. Worcester 5 with a high of 18. Springbok starting off on 1, reaching a high of 20. And in Upington, expect some sunshine with a low of 4 and a high of 23. That's where we leave your weather for now. We'll bring another update in half an hour's time. But first, let's take a look at what you can expect on your roads, starting off in Gauteng and Guguletu. On the N2 inbound, there are traffic restrictions between the R300 and the airport due to roadworks. It's causing further congestion on this route. If you are taking the train this morning, just take note that the power failures on the northern line in Paarl. Now, the train shuttle and replacement bus services are in operation, so you can expect a delay of 40 to 60 minutes. So please accommodate for this extra travel time this morning. That's where we leave your traffic for now. That was it.
Oh no, 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 no. No gum. No gum, please. Take the gum out.
Now we turn our attention to the power of sport to transform communities, but I think every soccer fan's ultimate dream has to be to play alongside their country's soccer heroes. So this weekend, a few incredibly lucky fans will get the chance to go head-to-head with some of the nation's top players at the Kick24 Tournament, and it's taking place here in the Mother City. And the contest will see several amateur players taking on a Kick24 All-Star team made up of legendary soccer pros and celebrities. And we've got players from All-Star team here this morning. Welcome our pros, Nathan Paulse and Eleazar Rodgers. I like the way you turned the legends of the game. Feel like a legend? No, gentlemen, I think both of you deserve massive congratulations on your seasons. Ajax and Wits have had probably dream seasons in terms of where they started out the year and where they've ended. I'm going to start with you, Mr. Rodgers. Congratulations.
Good morning. Thank you, brother.
What a high you must be on. Put that season in perspective for us, man.
Well, for me, it's a personal best. I think it's definitely a dream come true. We managed to win the top 8 and the league as well. And I mean, that's every footballer's dream. And also for me as a footballer personally, I managed to play for the national team as well. And yeah, for me, there's no words to explain how good the season was for me. And yeah, I'm just proud that, you know, I could achieve that. And yeah.
Oh, long may it rain. Hopefully that's just scratching the surface of what 2018 is going to reveal as well. Nathan, awesome to catch up with you. Always here, whenever there is an awesome project, you somehow manage to get yourself involved in that way. But quickly run me through Ajax's season, a top 10 finish. I would imagine a bit of a shaky start to the season in terms of where the team's headspace was. You guys happy with this? Was this the goal that you had set out for yourselves?
Morning, Graham. It's been a bit of a turbulent season. Yeah. You know, I'm started off quite badly, but thank God the season's done. You know, I don't think our ambitions was to finish in a number 10. So a top 8 spot would have been ideal. But in saying that, you know, it's been a tough season. So I think we enjoying this time off and just have to reset, you know, for next season. And see what it holds.
And it does look like the team has had to regroup through that, so come through the fire, and it does seem like the team unit is there. But now, you talk about building a team spirit. You guys are going to be playing with the enemy, rather, against some amateurs. Talk me through this tournament. The Kick24 tournament just looks like an unbelievable opportunity for some amateur players to play against you guys. But how does it feel, from your perspective, to play with guys that you're used to playing against?
Yeah, for me, you know, that's where we started as young football players, and for the guys who are still dreaming to be where we are, you know, it's an opportunity for them to obviously prove what they can do, you know. So these tournaments or these games, you know, we can give them the opportunity to play against us, you know, and just give them part of that dream, you know, so that they can live it.
But then do you give them the full experience and go hard, or do you kind of tap off a little bit there?
I don't know about Eleazar, but I can't go any other way. that's just how I am.
It's always hard.
Yeah, but no, look, it's for a good cause, you know. It's saying no to gangs, saying no to drugs, you know. And I often ask myself when we tell kids and teens, you know, you shouldn't be involved in gangs, you shouldn't be involved in drugs. I always say, okay, then what's the alternative option?
Yeah.
And I think us being involved as PSL players, you know, we need to have a stronger stance, you know, and a show an alternative, which is being like us, which is aspiring towards be like us, you know. And as I've said, we have to speak up, you know, and use who we are. So being involved in events like these is amazing, you know. I think I'm from Athlone, Eleazar is from
Kales River.
From Kales River. It's both areas where you find gangs, you find drugs, and we've come from that. So, you know, it's a way of us saying that, look here, we have reached the level that we are at now, and if you have
despite
dreams,
the challenges,
you know, and just inspire kids, you know, by being who we are.
I love that. Even if you connect with just one kid from your hood, from your community, you're making an unbelievable difference.
Exactly.
But amateurs, you have been warned, they are not going to go light at all. If there are celebs involved as well, guys, brace yourselves. But thank you so much, gentlemen. Awesome to have you here, and enjoy it, and enjoy the post-season, pre-season break. Looking forward to the next season with glee. And of course, you can go and support your favourite stars at the Kick24 tournament. We'll see you after the break. Welcome back, you beautiful people. Thank you so much for tuning in. It's a Thursday morning. Time to kick it off with our local entertainment news. I normally judge Leanne's face to see what our stars have been up to, but I can't read
you. You should read the body language.
Yeah. Body language is all good. I'm loving this one. Listen, Seven Alon fans are in for a big treat because the iconic soap is going back to the roots by changing its theme song back to that famous violin.
It doesn't feel like Seven Alon if it's not that.
But that's a soap, that's a good soapy theme song, man.
Exactly. Everyone loves it. And of course, this is the one that we all came to know and love when the soap was first introduced. So while the reasoning behind the change, it hasn't been announced yet, the return to the old jingle has us all feeling a little bit of nostalgia and has us wondering, do you think they might be reintroducing some old faces again? Are we going to be seeing that?
Well, we'll have to watch to find out. Bring in the old favorites.
Yeah. Are you a Lon watcher, Graham?
Sporadically throughout my life, man.
How about you, Jose?
I watched, like, there was a point where, you know, I should probably not tell you this.
No, you
used to watch it so much, but when the end credits, everyone's, the characters' names came on, I would read them and eventually I remembered them.
Oh my God. One day when we have the time, we're gonna put that to the test.
Oh my gosh, okay, on to other good news. We all know that Black Coffee, one of the biggest DJs and hit makers from the African continent and now all across the world as well. But now, Black Coffee is expanding his empire and he's now adding club owner to his title list. I mean, this guy is amazing. So he took to Twitter and he announced that he's going to be buying, or he's already bought, a venue in Soweto called Zone 6. Very, very well known. Of course, Casper Your Vest launched his latest album, Tuto, there.
Iconic, yeah.
So it's one that's very, very much loved by the public. And there's no telling whether he hasn't said yet whether he's going to be renovating the space, who's going to be playing there, whether he himself is going to be playing there. But it's very exciting because he says it's all about the culture and trying to influence the culture of music there. He's very, very serious about
that. I'm glad that he's chosen to launch his brand there. Yeah. That spot. That's awesome.
Good
man.
News. Good news indeed.
He should add some like coffee drinks to the menu.
Oh, man.
A little coffee
Six
shop.
Or seven alone.
Anyway, that's the entertainment news we have for you. Let us know what stories you're keeping up with. And of course, hashtag Expresso Show.
Oh, the things we talk about while other people are reporting on entertainment news. JP Sebastian is here and we're going to be chatting movies in a little bit. But before we do that, let's take a look at what's happening at the box office.
This is the South African top 5 box office hits over the last weekend. Ralph Knight probably won't remember this weekend, but not for partying too hard. It only makes 5. Unable to beat Baywatch for rough laughs, Treading Water won down to 4th place. Last making 3rd place, The Mummy is the first nail in the coffin to the upcoming so-called Dark Universe monster movies. 9 months training, 7 kilos more muscle, and eventually a 5-month baby bump, Gal Gadot put in the work at number 2's Wonder Woman. And director Brian Fee calls his Cars 3 a love letter to racing and the American way. It's also this week's number 1.
I would like to launch a probe into how Cars beat Wonder Woman. Anyways, I'm not going to say anything about that. Wonder Woman should be number 1 for like the next 6 months. But JP Sebastian...
You've seen how she was narrowing her eyes. She was doing the Clint Eastwood thing when she saw Cars beat Wonder Woman.
I was like, what? 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 I want to see the statistics. Anyways, are you well?
I'm doing good, yes.
That's wonderful. Thank you. We're talking movies today, and one of the very first movies we're talking about is Everything, Everything.
Everything, Everything,
yes,
ma'am, indeed.
Everything is it.
Ah, Lauryn Hill.
Hello.
Old school. Everything, Everything is a young adult romance, where the story being, as it always is, the pretty boy moves in next door and you are the girl who has a terminal illness that doesn't allow you to go outside. Okay, so maybe not every movie, but...
Wow, but we've seen a couple of those, you know?
For some reason, interestingly, like, young adult movies have an interest in, like, one or at least maybe both of the characters.
Dying?
Yeah, well, there was The Fault in Our Stars, there was Me Ill and the Dying Girl, but this one's got the dude Nick Robinson, who was in Jurassic World most recently, but they're both newcomers, and a girl with an interesting name. Her name's Amandla Stenberg.
Amandla?
Yes, indeed.
Yes.
Which is pretty cool. It doesn't look too badly acted, and these are... actors who are busy proving themselves and whatnot. But yeah, story being that she's trapped inside like for 18 years of her life. Her mother's very concerned about this diagnosis that she has, and the boy next door keeps texting her and emailing her, as boys do, trying to get her outside. Not a horror, in fact, a romance. He's not trying to kill her. She takes a risk for love. Oh, look at her, you're like, oh.
I'm gonna love this movie.
Doughy-eyed already, so. Yeah. She risks everything for love, Leanne. And she leaves the house and potentially, you know,
dies.
Potentially. Okay. I'm not giving away anything, although I haven't seen it myself. But don't look too bad for young.
I like that. I think that's wonderful. I think we all need a little mushy, smooshy.
Yeah, with a sense of danger, you know?
Okay, wonderful. The Promise looks promising.
Ha ha ha. So, speaking of sense of danger, this is a historical romance, I suppose, historical drama, more precisely. So, it's based on a little known and a little spoken about genocide that actually happened in the Ottoman Empire, which is present-day Turkey, the Armenian genocide of 1915. And that's interesting because this is barely acknowledged by a lot of governments in the world, in fact, even. So it stars great actors like Oscar Isaac, who you probably saw in Star Wars, and Batman himself, the Batman, what's his name, Ben Affleck, Christian Bale. Yeah. So there's this love triangle romance that's set in the midst of this impending doom, this impending dread in an empire that's collapsing, and this genocide that's about to happen. From the guy who made Hotel Rwanda, so if you're into that thing.
Okay, wonderful. Well, that was the movies that is coming up this weekend, but we're also talking about one of the most anticipated blockbusters of the year, Transformers The Last Night. We're going to be chatting about that a little bit later on, so stay tuned. Of course, if you want to see any of these movies, be sure to check out your nearest New Metro Cinema.
Find the best entertainment at New Metro Cinemas. It's your scene.
Well, from movies to music, one of South Africa's favourites, Questa. Before he performs, let's first talk Samas.
So this morning we're joined by multiple award winner, or should I rather say six-time Sama award-winning rapper Questa, known as the King of African Rap, whose 2015 album Dakar 2 brought him so much success at the 23rd South African Music Awards that took place last month. And in fact, as they are now known throughout Mzansi, the Questa Awards. that's what they're saying,
dog. I don't know, but yeah, it's got a ring to it.
Big time,
it's
congratulations to you, man. Thank you, bro. You owned the night. You were so humble in your acceptance speeches, every single one of them. Almost seemed like you were surprised, you weren't expecting it, but then you were grateful at the same time. What were your actual emotions throughout those features?
Look, man, the biggest feeling was, I mean, there was a little sense of, I don't know, sort of feeling like you deserved it because of the work you put in a year. I guess you'd feel like that, but the biggest feeling was that of gratitude more than anything, you know?
Yeah.
The fact that whenever they announced my name, when they were announcing the nominations or the nominees and stuff like that, how everybody kind of really wanted me to win.
Yes.
You know, that for me was like, wait, what? And I'm like, because they're going, and the nominees are so-and-so, Questa for Dakar, and everyone had it. And I'm like, y'all want me to win? You know, so that for me was it was even bigger than going up there to actually accept the things, the fact that people actually wanted me to walk up there and get it.
And I'm assuming it started off with a little bit of pressure as well, because on night one, you win Best Collaboration.
Yeah.
So that already sets it up.
Yeah, already.
And then all the noms the next night. Was there one that you weren't quite expecting that when it came, your heart kind of went, yes.
Album of the Year.
Album of the Year?
Yeah, Album of the Year was like, I mean, I really feel like I was making some of the best music I could make, right? I feel like I outdid myself with regards to the music that I'm able to make kind of thing. And I felt like I wanted that more than anything. So I wanted, the recognition for that, so people can go. It's one thing to win Best Rap, right? It's one thing to be Best Male. But to win Album of the Year means, out of all the things we've listened to, out of all the projects and the bodies of work we've listened to, yours got a little bit, you know, ahead of everybody else's. And for me, I was stoked about that one.
When you were on the stage, the fam was there, everyone whom I've known at least to have been part of your journey as well. And you spoke about a couple of artists and people that you're putting on. What are you currently working on right now?
I'm already trying to make music from a Questa point of view again, you know. I mean, I have been for a bit, but as Rap Life, as the unit, we're working on a duo called TLT, who's going to be dropping new stuff. They have a song out right now called Nice Life Problems. And also, Kid X is going to be dropping his album, Thank the King, you know. As Rap Life, just a lot of music is going to come out, you know. I want to make global music, you know what I mean? I feel like it's also for my growth as an artist, I kind of have to delve into this, some unknown territories, you know, for me to also grow. So I'm doing a whole lot of that.
As South Africans, as the Expresso family, we are so, so proud of you, man.
Thank you very much.
So make sure that you do stay tuned to your Feel Good Breakfast show. We've got music coming from the King of African Rap right here.
Oh, Questa in the house. Love, love, love him. Well, still to come on your Feel Good Breakfast show, we are looking at what's trending this morning. And the Game of Thrones cast are all over the internet because they decided to do a really iconic song. You want to stay tuned for that.
Yeah, and quite ironic as well when you look at how many of the cast members are actually remaining from that original group. And then, of course, Questa, we've got him all morning. He's going to perform, show us some of that Sama winning magic. We'll see you for that after the break. Good.
Welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's Expresso right here on SABC3.
And we have found a throne in our studio this morning. Why? Because the king is here. Kat, I think, is as pumped up as I am to have Questa in the house.
So it's time for some music on your Feel Good Breakfast Show and performing hits from his multiple Sama Award-winning record, Dakar 2. Here's Questa with One Day.
When I get up, in the zone, I'll send them home. When I get up, all I know is I'm a hero. And he's a hero. She's a hero. We all heroes.
Hey! One day when I get up,
when I get up,
I'll turn the seasons
over.
I'll
send them home. Na 10-year-old Tepo is a smart kid. Angatshelwanga ngeke aphume ejardini. Uhlala la endlini ngisho naseklasini. Kala notishera lo njalo ushere isikafutini. Kodwa uTepo akekho sharp ekhaya. Tepo uyashawa ekhaya. But Tepo smiles, Tepo sings, noma eshawa edlala. Noma uTepo yingane, kodwa uTepo uyamazi ngoba uTepo
uwena. Cross my fingers, cross my toes. Cross my heart, my nose don't grow. Wash my mouth out now with soap.
I'll be a hero, this I know. Yes, I know. One day when I get old, when I get old, I'll turn the seas to gold. And this ain't no more for
souls. I'll send them home.
It must have been heaven that sent Sarah down, cause Sarah's proud, you'll never see Sarah down. Surrounded by love all around, poor Sarah, but I tried, but she couldn't keep her uncle out. Good gracious, you're getting good grades, still the truth is being viewed as an accusation. It's amazing, no more Sarah in God, not to Sarah or Mars, but to Sarah who we're now.
Cross my toes, cross my heart, my nose don't grow. Wash my mouth out now with soap. I'll be a hero, yes I know. Yes I know. One day when I get old,
when I get old,
I'll turn the seas to gold.
And say
no more the souls. And make the stars get closer.
One day
when I get old,
when I get old,
I'll turn the seas to gold.
And say
no more the souls. Cross my toes, cross my heart, my nose don't grow. Wash my mouth out now with soap. I'll be a hero, yes I know. Yes I know. One day when I get old, I'll turn the seas to gold. And send home all the soldiers and make the stars come closer. One day when I get old, I'll turn the seas to gold. And send home all the soldiers.
Cross my fingers, cross my toes, cross my heart, my nose don't grow. Wash my mouth out now with soap. I'll be a hero, yes I know, yes I know. One day when I get older, I'll turn the seas to soda and send home all the soldiers and make the stars come closer. One day when I get older, I'll turn the seas to soda and send home all the soldiers and make the stars come closer.
Shout out to Sara and Tepo.
Come on, man. Too good. So do you still have that? One day, something will happen. Do you have a one day right now?
There's still one day. I mean, there's a lot of one days, especially in this song. It's not just for me. It's like a lot of people. It's like just aspirations and dreams. You know?
Nice one, man. Yeah. We feel you, man. Thank you so much for sharing the music with us. Hopefully you enjoyed it. At home, let us know what you thought about it on our Expresso Morning Show SABC3 Facebook page.
Oh, well done, boy. Unbelievable, Questo here all morning. So sit tight for another performance. But right now, let's get back into our official duties with the news.
In the national news this morning, Energy Minister Mamoloki Kubai says government will review its nuclear plans as part of its response to recession. Kubai in Moscow for the Atom Expo nuclear conference and leading a delegation from South Africa also says that she sees nuclear energy as part of a diverse energy mix, including renewable resources and coal. Meanwhile, the Department of Energy confirmed that Minister Kubai has agreed with the head of Russia's state nuclear corporation, Rosatom, that their technical teams will initiate discussions on cooperation. The city of Johannesburg has announced commuters who use RioVia and Metro bus services will have to pay more for their rides from the 1st of July. The city's mayoral committee on transport has approved a 6% fare increase for RioVia and a 6.2% hike for Metro bus for the 2017-2018 financial year. The city of Cape Town also has transport plans for July as it will roll out a 6.8 billion rand in public transport upgrades for a new train line, a MyCity rollout for the Metro Southeast area and road corridors. Now moving further abroad, Saudi Arabia's king has appointed his son, Mohammed bin Salman, as crown prince, replacing his nephew, Mohammed bin Nayef, as first in the line to the throne. King Salman's decree means that Prince Mohammed bin Salman will become deputy prime minister while continuing to serve as defense minister as well. Meanwhile, Prince Mohammed bin Nayef has been removed from his role as head of domestic security and has pledged allegiance to the new crown prince, his younger cousin. And then finally, Britain's Queen Elizabeth II has delivered her opening of Parliament speech at the House of Lords, in which a host of proposed new laws designed to prepare the UK for a smooth and orderly departure from the EU were announced. The Queen's speech had a huge focus on Brexit and the fight against terrorism, but made no mention of US President Donald Trump's state visit. Meanwhile, Prince Philip, the 96-year-old husband of the Queen, has been admitted to hospital with an infection and missed the formal opening of Parliament. Well, that was your 7 o'clock news update. Let's get our very first look at what's happening in the world of sport. Here's Graham.
So we broached cricket first, and clearly battling to make the transition into the shortest format of the game. The Proteas slumped to a 9-wicket loss against England last night in the first T20 game of their 3-match series. Batting first, South Africa made it to 142 for 3, thanks to a 110-run 4th-wicket stand between Fahad Bahdin and captain AB de Villiers. In reply, England easily chased down the winning target with 5 overs remaining. Of course, match 2 of the series takes place tomorrow at the County Ground from 6 o'clock SA time. Then on to football, Mamelodi Sundowns earned a point in the CAF Champions League last night after they played out to a goalless draw with Tunisian side Esperance. The result sees Sundowns move up one place to second in Group C with 5 points from their 4 games played. Elsewhere in the Champions League last night, we saw Zanaco beat Cotton Sport 1-0, Al Ahly suffering a 2-0 loss to Wydad AC. Well, Al Ahly Tripoli, they saw out a 4-2 win over Caps United. In staying with the beautiful game, Portugal earned their first victory at the Confederations Cup last night. It was after seeing out a narrow 1-0 win over host Russia in Moscow. A towering header from Portuguese captain Cristiano Ronaldo in the first 10 minutes of the game proved to be the match winner in the end. The night's other fixture saw New Zealand, despite a very strong start to their game, knocked out of the tournament after a 2-1 loss to Mexico. Tonight's fixture sees Cameroon up against Australia, while Chilli, they've got a tough test ahead against World Cup holders Germany. Then on to tennis, world number 8 Dominic Thiem has been knocked out of the Halle Open yesterday. It was after suffering a straight sets loss to Robin Haas in the second round. After going down 6-3 in the first, Thiem fought back to force a tiebreak in the second. However, it was Haas who came out on top to progress to the third round. Some other results from the day saw Alexander Zverev beat Philip Kohlschreiber, while Bernard Tomic, he lost out to Richard Gasquet. And that's where we leave our sport for now.
Well, let's take another look at what you can expect on the in the roads this morning. We start off in Gauteng in Germiston. Expect slow-moving traffic on the N3 highway between Voortrekker Road and Main Reef Road. If you're in Cape Town and Plumstead, there's also some slow-moving traffic on the M5 northbound from Dick Burton Road and the N2 interchange. And the roads are wet this morning, so allow for some extra travel time. That's where we leave your traffic for now, but let's see, take another look at what you can expect in the weather. And it seems like most parts in the northeast Eastern region can experience some sunny conditions. However, rainfall and chilly temperatures can be expected along the garden route. We start off with temperatures in Polokwane, a low of 6 with a high of 22, Mbombela 11, 29, Pretoria 7, 22, Johannesburg 4 with a high of 21, Mahikeng 4, 24, Klerksdorp 1, 24, Kimberley 3 with a high of 22. Bloemfontein starting off a cool minus 2, reaching a high of 21. Sunshine can be expected in Richards Bay, a low of 16 with a high of 19. Pietermaritzburg 9, 27, Durban 16, 25, Mthatha 6 with a high of 26. East London 0, 23, Cradock also starting off on 0 with a high of 21. Port Elizabeth 9 with a high of 18, George 8, 15, Sutherland starting off a cool minus 5 with a high of only 7 degrees Celsius, Cape Town partly cloudy with expected showers, a low of 8 with a high of 16, Worcester starting off on 0 with a high of 12, Springbok today 2 reaching a high of 15, and in Upington expect some sunshine, a low of 4 with a high of 22. That's where we leave your weather for this morning.
Book on Travel Start. We will turn your guilt trips into good trips.
So cometh the Thursday, cometh the hashtag TBT. A little factoid for you. Did you know that in 1886, a whole 100 years before I was born, one of the largest gifts of friendship was given from France to America, and this arrived in the form of the Statue of Liberty, or otherwise known as...
Statue de la Liberté. Okay, I'm going to try that again. Statue de la Liberté.
There we go. Now, she arrived in New York City on the 19th of June, and it's been her home ever since. So since, of course, she's a representation of all things freedom and democracy in the United States of America. So for this Throwback Thursday, we're going to head all the way back to find out some unknown facts or facts that you might not have known about this iconic landmark.
Well, here we go. This incredible landmark stands tall and proud, and from the ground to the top of the torch measures a whopping 93 meters tall. Get this, she has a 35-foot waistline, hello, and wears a size 879 shoe.
What a Wonder Woman. What a Wonder Woman. Let me tell ya. Now, did you know that the 7 spikes on her crown are a representation of the 7 oceans and 7 continents of the world? And this is a symbol of universal concept of liberty.
I absolutely love that. Anyways, so...
You absolutely love that? Okay.
Listen, I can speak English, but I want to speak French. So, you know the saying, lightning doesn't strike twice.
Yeah,
well,
yeah,
in this case, it certainly does. 600 times, in fact. The Statue of Liberty is a huge monument made from metal, so you can really expect... Can you really expect anything
600
less?
Times has been struck by
like
shocking stuff. Now, earlier on this week, we acknowledged World Refugee Day. So it is fitting that we discuss the Statue of Liberty being a symbol of immigration during the second half of the 19th century. In fact, over 9 million immigrants came to America. And the first thing they were greeted upon arrival was... The Statue
I
of
love
Liberty
that. That is amazing.
Like, that's when you know, like, coming to America, welcome. You know you're there when you see the Statue
And you're
of
greeted by a French woman. This is awesome.
So like, which, bonjour.
Well, which famous landmark would you like to visit and why? You can let us know your thoughts using that hashtag Expresso Show and Throwback Thursday. Wee wee.
Oh, well, listen, from Throwback Thursday to checking out what's happening on social media, remember, you can connect with us. We're on Facebook, we're on Twitter, as well as Instagram. Remember, our hashtag, Expresso Show. And this morning, we are focusing on the hashtag England versus SA, and not that good. Even Varshini says, feeling sad for South Africa, most loved and lost team. Here we have one just showing us a picture, Caribbean Power at Lords. Then Suyash says, the Englishmen are so colorful. This very attribute is depicted by the frequency which they change their cricket jersey colors. Hashtag English, England versus South Africa. Well, that's where we leave it with you for this morning. You can continue to connect with us on social media. Remember our hashtag, Expresso Show.
Mm-hmm. So we're gonna take a very quick air break and come firmly back down to earth. We have obviously dealt with some ridiculous weather and conditions, and Nisna still reeling in the aftermath of those fires. We're going to bring you an update.
Yeah, and then something very exciting. The Dance Domination Championships are currently underway, and we've got a South African team that's taking part in the disco dance.
Hey. Uh-huh.
It's alive. It's alive.
I'm a dreamer. A doer.
I know the hustle.
I just need my money to hustle for me.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
At Samsung, we develop technology so you can live life. Samsung, a way of life.
Welcome back. Thank you so much for tuning in. You are live with Expresso. And of course, we are going to have a little bit of fun now as we turn our attention to what's been trending online. Some random, some funny, some very heartfelt videos and pics surfacing today. But this one is a big one. Why? Because Game of Thrones is coming.
Absolutely.
Yes?
It's coming very soon. But I think a lot of people will get the irony in this and why it's so funny and why it's trending. The Game of Thrones cast sing a song that's definitely what no one has been able to do. Gloria Gaynor's I Will Survive. Let's check it out. It's quite interesting.
I will survive.
Oh, as long as
I know how to
love, I know
I'll stay alive.
Have a good for my life
to live, and
I've got all my love to give.
And I'll survive.
I will
survive.
Hey, hey.
Of course, a lot of them have not survived. Tyrion, though, however, yeah, still ending it off there.
I'd love to know
how
many of them have actually survived. That is brilliant. The cast must be loving that. And you, of course, can look forward to the brand new season coming soon. So now I'm going to hit you right in the feels with two beautiful stories. Now, this first one takes us to the Grand Park Zoo in Seoul, South Korea, where CCTV footage caught this very dramatic moment when a baby elephant fell into a pond and clearly wasn't able to swim. But two of the adult elephants quickly came to its rescue. They were able to push it up. But look at them problem solving now. Look at the problem solving going on there into the shallow end. Oh, look at that poor little thing's trunk.
Oh, nunus.
Well, I suppose if ever you were going to... And look at that. Come on.
I love them.
Look at how they're using their trunks. Hey.
They're so family oriented.
And I suppose if you're going to fall into water, you want a trunk. Yeah. You want a little snorkel that you can use. But
and they help him.
But I think what gets to me is you can see the panic set in. That shows a level of emotional awareness, intelligence. Yeah. That's absolutely beautiful, man. Well, that's all we've got time for this morning. So hopefully that's brought a smile to your face today.
Well, thank you very much, team. Some very, very interesting stories there indeed, and great to see how those elephants got together as a team to work towards that problem. Now, the country's hearts and might went all into addressing the raging fire that burned through the parts or through parts of the garden route after the Cape storm 2 weeks ago. Now, collective relief and rebuilding efforts are still going towards the Knysna region, in which hundreds of homes were destroyed by the devastating fire. Now, Knysna Fire Chief Clinton Manuel is joining us on the line to tell us a bit more about what exactly is happening there. Chief Manuel, good morning to you.
Good morning, Katlesa. Good morning to your listeners.
Thank you so much. Now, what is the extent of the damage caused by the fire to the garden route so far that you've assessed?
Katlesa, what we are estimating is that currently we're standing between Knysna and Plettenberg Bay, around about 22,000 hectares of area affected, over 400 formal housing and about 200 informal housing. So the extent and the damage is huge.
And what are the relief efforts that are needed right now to rebuild the region, and how long do you think this might take?
Well, relief efforts will obviously be ongoing, and what the municipality is currently doing is trying to keep people fed, keep people warm, keep them clothed, keep them housed, until housing can be provided, because it would be best to provide the housing and put people in their own environment where they have got the privacy, they've got the security of home. So that's product number one. Mm-hmm. Obviously, the municipality is looking at alternative type of housing in order to make that happen. And then we're also sitting with formal housing that's been lost. And a lot of the people are probably staying with friends, with family, or staying at guest houses in Knysna. And their homes obviously need to be rebuilt. And we're also sitting with those who are insured and those who are not insured. This rebuild process is going to take many, many years. It's not going to happen overnight. Yeah. So there's a long road ahead for Knysna still with this process.
Yeah, and of course we've got to talk about the firefighters from the Knysna team itself and beyond, who all rallied together in their efforts, and we highly commend all of you. Thank you so much for what you've done. What is the status of any of the firefighters who've been injured during all of these efforts?
Well, we do know that we had two loss of lives. The one is at Bradley, a volunteer firefighter, and the other one, Mr. Blau, he was a contractor with the MTOs. And sadly, we lost their lives, but they rushed in to protect people's property and to try and put a stop to this fire. And sadly, they lost their lives. We had a couple of injuries, at least one friend. He's still recovering from his burn wounds. And then we also had a couple of firefighters who had sprained ankles, because remember the terrain we work on is steep slopes, it's down into valleys, a couple of burns, But overall, the guys are coping well. They are upbeat. Nobody's gone and said, look, I want to be in a race. I want to put my feet up. The guys are still out in the fire line. So I'm speaking to you, we're out in the fire line now. My heartfelt gratitude to every firefighter came to Nasna from all over South Africa and came to give their off-duty time and suffered and endured the very extreme conditions one can face in any fire and to try and put an end to this fire.
Yeah, and please do send our condolences and our love to the families that have been affected that, of course, lost loved ones due to this. And finally, I understand that a benefit concert that features the likes of artists like Majozi and Good Luck and Rubber Duck, just to name a few, is going to be taking place this Sunday in Pretoria, and people like Casper Lee are also crowdfunding online. But what can people from outside Knysna and the Garden Route do to help disaster relief efforts, and how can they ensure that they are donating and contributing to, of course, good causes that are going to be going towards the relief efforts there?
Yeah, firstly, I think it's extremely noble of these artists to put this concert together and making a benefit concert for the victims of this fire. So, yeah, it's noble. My heartfelt thanks to them as well. Mm-hmm. I do want to encourage people to support it, and then whatever proceeds, whatever donations people want to make, make sure they go to worthy organizations. Make sure they go to reputable organizations. We don't want scammers to capitalize out of this disaster. Mm-hmm. The municipality, people can visit the municipality's website. They will find a link that deals with donations. I can guarantee you that those actually do go to the fire victims and start rebuilding the process of putting people back in their homes. So people, donors, private donors out there, corporates, and just be careful where they put their money in, and not to allow scammers actually to run away with everything that's supposed to be going to your fire victims.
All right, thank you so much for joining us and giving us an update. That is the Fire Chief of Knysna, Chief Clinton Manuel. And in fact, let's all just put our heads and our hearts together to help and pray for the people affected by the fires in the Garden Route. And of course, you can head on over to our website, expressoshow.com, to find a comprehensive list of where and how you can help.
I just want to say we salute each and every one of you that's been serving during this time. Thank you so much. It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Time for us to turn our attention to some fitness. I feel like we haven't done this in a while. Sheena Abrams with us in studio. And we're going to do a full body workout. A very good morning to you too.
Yeah.
We're doing a full body workout. It's winter. People are now getting lazy. Some people are actually more active in the gym during winter. So you... what have you got planned for us
today? So if you're just at home and you only have 20 minutes to get ready, get your workout done and then go to work, then we've got 6 exercises that we're going to go through. So what you want to do is we're going to do 10 reps of every exercise. We'll just show 4 for every single exercise. But when you're at home, you're doing 10 reps. After you've done all 6 exercises for 10 reps, you take a minute break, and then you keep on doing as many rounds as you can for that 20 minutes.
In the 20 minutes. Yes. Okay, cool.
So the first one we're going to start off is jumping jacks. So it gives you a nice warm-up. We'll just do 4 of them. So remember, touching nice at the top. Try and clap your hands together so that you really warm up the shoulders and that you warm up the hips. Okay, and remember from there, you can also take a skipping rope if you need to warm up for 2 or 3 minutes. It is winter, so get a really, really nice warm up before you start. From there, so you'll do 20 of those. This is the only exercise you're going to do 20. The rest are all going to be 10. You're going to get onto your back so that now we can work the stomach. From here, we're going to do full sit-ups. You want to touch your toes and touch back. Remember, you can do crunches if you can't do sit-ups. So we're going to do 10. You'll do 10 of those. We're going to just do one more. And then from there, straight into your next exercise. For the ladies, you like to get the thighs, the inner thigh, the quads, and the glutes. So we're gonna do a sumo squat. So feet further apart, take your toes nice and out. As low as you can go, hands up and back down. So keep the weight into your heels. You don't want the weight into your toes. Okay, we're gonna do 4 of those. But at home, you're going to do 10. So we'll do one more, all the way down and up. The next one, going to the upper body. So if you can either do the push-ups on your knees or you can do it in the normal push-up position. So from here, we're going to go into a push-up, lock it out, and then to a side plank. Feet on top of each other and up. Back down to your plank, push-up, lock out, turn over, and up. So you're working the upper body as well as your core. All the way out and up. We'll do one more. From there, push-up, lock out, all the way up. And core. From there, back to the legs. So we're gonna go into the hamstrings. A nice step forward, drop that knee to the ground, lock out, and back up. So that's your lunge. And now we're gonna go into a reverse lunge. So the same leg, pop it up, and then change sides. So you wanna do a forward lunge, forward,
touch, and then a reverse lunge.
Oh.
And up.
So you get the front, you get the hamstring, and you get the glute. Then our last one. So again, this one is nice and explosive.
Yeah.
I'll show it. You're gonna go into the plank from there, frog up and back down. Back out into your plank, frog up, chest up, and down. So we're gonna
She said she's just gonna show
me. We're gonna show it.
Well, Sheila, thank you so much for that. Hope you enjoyed that one. It's a quick full body workout for you to do in winter so that you know they say summer bodies are made in winter.
That's right.
Yeah, woo! But summer moves are made all year long, baby. Oh yeah, all right. Listen, 2,000 dancers right now from 25 countries, in fact, will be taking part in the International Dance Organization's World Disco Dance Championships in the Czech Republic.
What a title. Well, amongst the competitors will be a group of dancers who are proving that Bloemfontein has some serious talent for disco dance.
Like a bloom. Like a bloom. Like a bloom. Like a bloom. Like a bloom.
Now, it might seem like a regular day in Bloemfontein, but there's a dance troupe that's hard at work preparing to represent South Africa in the World Disco Dance Championships. And I think they're going to prove it's about so much more than just hairspray. Let's check it out.
Dance Domination Dance Studio has perfected the art of disco dance in South Africa and holds virtually every major national title, with 26 dancers heading to the World Championships.
It will be the third year that we will be competing at the Disco World Championships. It's my passion working with these beautiful, talented dancers to help them to grow in their talent. And it's been my aim to take as many dancers to the worlds this year. We're proud to say that we are taking 26 out of our studio, and we're going to do our best, and we're going to try to make South Africa proud. We have two disco small groups competing, age groups 11 and under, 12 to 15. Then we've got the 16 and over formation team, which consists of 21 dancers, and then two solo disco freestyle and three duo couples that's competing this year.
Dancing as a perfectly synchronized group is particularly difficult in the disco genre, and the teams require a lot of discipline and long hours of training.
I started dancing at the age of 6, and I guess since then I've built that discipline. I mean, it's more cardio, it's more fitness, it's more exercise. I'm stronger as a dancer, and collectively as this group, we're stronger too. It's hard hours, we're training really hard for worlds, but I think we can really do this as dedicated, disciplined dancers.
As I learned as a dancer is that teamwork is very important, and one of the teams are called Synergy. That means all of the dancers come together to form a unity to work together as a strong group.
Disco freestyle combines dance with acrobatics and tumbling, so these dancers are super fit and flexible to maintain high energy for their full routine.
Disco freestyle is by anders van a group dance. You dance alleen en daar al die focus is op jou specifiek. Ek sien meestal uit om na competities toe te gaan om saam met al my vriende te wees en te sien hoe goed almal doen. Wat ek meestal uitsien vir wanneer soos jy gaan is wanneer ek die gevoel beleef wanneer ek op die vloer staan en dat ek weet ek het baie hard gewerk om op daai posisie te kom. Ek wil net sien op soos waar lê ek op die wêreldranglys.
The Dance Domination team is formidable on stage, but there's a support system behind the scenes that makes sure that everything comes together, and it's made up of all the moms. So what is your job here at Dance Domination?
I help with the fundraising and the support.
Okay, so we have the banker over here. And mom, I see she's in charge of the lipstick. What is your job?
I do the makeup.
Uh-huh. Again, what does it take? I see this crimped hair, the colors are amazing. How do you put your looks together?
Well, we look at what will work on stage because it's really important the girls do stand out when they on the group on stage, that you can really see the whole picture.
Now, the whole picture does, of course, include big hair. Mom, what is your job here?
Well, I normally babysit and see that everybody's there, and I like to help with the hair as well.
Basically, I'm known as the lash queen. Everybody comes to me for their lashes, but not only that, I also help with stoning some of the costumes to make sure that they really sparkle when they get out there on the stage.
Disco looks like a lot of fun, but are those flashy moves as easy as they appear?
Okay, Tim, so I taught you how to do a twirl. So now I'm gonna do one and then you're gonna do one.
Sure.
Okay, so it's boom. Okay. You try.
Okay, I'm not quite perfect at it. These guys are pretty hard to keep up with, so I'm more than confident they're going to do us proud all the way in the Czech Republic. Thank you so much and good luck.
It's an honor. Thank you very much.
Oh, I need to catch my breath though. Oh, yeah. Oh, so hard.
Like a bloom.
Lekker Blue.
I thought you were having like a situation.
No, it's my disco dance. You know, okay. Gotta get it ready, man. Gotta whip it a bit. Okay, all right. Anyway, while you both appreciate my awesome dancing, we're gonna take a break. When we come back, listen, TLC is working on a new album after how many years now?
15 years. So wow. Amaze. And then, of course, a movie that we are talking about after the break, Transformers 5. Can you believe it? JP Sebastian's here and he'll give us all the details.
Struggle with commitment? Before trying anywhere else, book on Travel Start. We will turn your guilt trips into good trips. Book flights from 499 Rand. Only on travelstart.co.za.
Welcome back. We're live, large and in charge on your Feel Good Breakfast. So thank you for joining us on this Thursday morning. Now, if you missed it out on it yesterday was the highly anticipated Nedbank Passion Playoffs Finals, and it was a battle between the ladies as exercise captain Boiti Tulo was up against makeup captain Mihlalin Damase, and we knew it was going to be a battle, of course. I mean, Boiti has a legion of followers, in fact, 1.5 million followers. And of course, she's claimed landslide victories throughout the tournament so far. But also, on the other hand, Mihlali also has proved herself and stayed strong and comfortable up against her opponents. So it was really anyone's game.
Oh, man, and the ladies did deliver for that final battle. Get this, they raised the stakes. Sebwethi was tasked to use household furniture and materials you find in your house for a full-body workout, while Mihlali was tasked to do a Rocky Horror Picture Show-inspired makeup look on her model. So it was an epic and entertaining contest, to say the least. And, of course, the results were very, very close. But in the end, the fans voted, and Boiti claimed the victory, saw herself being crowned our champion of what was an epic battle. And I think she really did deserve this one. She was strong throughout the tournament.
The first title, she can claim it and lift it on high, eh? Well, anyway, make sure that you stay tuned to your Feel Good Breakfast show, because tomorrow we'll have both ladies here, and of course they'll be telling us about their battle stories, but most importantly also how they've turned their passions into profits. So don't miss out on that on your Feel Good Breakfast show tomorrow.
Thank you so much, guys. Time for us to talk movies. Now, famed director of cinema apocalypses, Michael Bay, is back at the wheel of a fifth robotic threat to Earth. Now, Transformers The Last Night picks up from the human war on the metal extraterrestrials, whose history, we learn, may rescue us from their threat to our future. Now, we'll hear if JP's Team Autobot or Team Decepticon...
Decepticon.
...after this sneak peek.
That cannon's pointing right at us. We're dead, man. I'm sorry. Shh. I almost had a heart attack.
Relax. We're covered. Covered.
I nearly screamed Bumblebee, but I hear it's not. JP Sebastian has more. How are you?
The entire studio was going, is that Bumblebee? Is that Bumblebee? And JP had to be calmed down. It's not Bumblebee.
It's not Bumblebee.
Although he is in this.
Okay, cool. Wonderful stuff. Okay, so listen, I see a lot of things there that is just piquing my interest. There's a black person in this movie. I love it because there never has been, and I love that it's culturally more inclusive now.
You got a Latina little girl there too.
Yes.
They're people of all sizes too,
nice.
and it's not all just revolving around the kids. Of course, Mark Wahlberg returns in this one. We all remember. I found the last Transformer. Greatest fact
of
all time.
Is that how we did it?
I don't know. It was probably a lot worse. But the story is, as you said. They find out something about the Transformers' past. And what I can say off the bat, I'm not giving anything away, you find out at the very start, that it's called The Last Knight because the Transformers were, in fact, the 12 knights of King Arthur. Yes.
Oh, really?
Yes, yes. And so there's this secret, mysterious scepter that they leave with the human beings that might rescue us from the threat, which I'm not going to give you any more details on, but just know that obviously the Decepticons, who are my guys, because they're the bad guys and try to destroy this movie at all turns. out to stem the salvation of humanity with this mysterious scepter.
Wow.
Yes, so I want to get straight into how much I hate this movie.
No. Okay, so you really don't love it. My thing is Optimus Prime going to get his butt kicked the entire movie through, and then in the last 5 minutes...
Could you not write the script like for everyone? Because
that's what happens in every
movie. The studio owes her money. She just... Or maybe it's just that predictable.
Yeah.
I'll be nice at least and say, like, for the hundreds of people who work on this movie, Michael Bay just does them such a disservice by... he doesn't have faith, I think, in the quality of the writing of this thing, because the script is bad. And
wow.
It's fine if an action movie has a story that you don't really care about because you just want to see the sort of motion of it. But if the camera keeps cutting every 4 seconds and if you don't frame up properly, you're not doing a service to the people who do the special effects for you.
Yeah.
Like who go through the hard work, girls and guys, for months to try and create these things.
Yeah.
So the attention span is horrid.
Yeah.
And weirdly, the most obvious things are over-explained. And the things that they really should give a bit more time to, they do as a little throwaway explainer because it's almost like filling a gap they forgot to mention and whatnot.
Okay.
I could go on for years.
I can see JP's actually upset about this movie.
I
can feel like the, you know. But let's find out very, very quickly, JP, how many popcorns do you give Transformers The Last Knight?
I'll very quickly say as well, for a 2.5-hour movie, I think it's going to earn 2 spots at least on my worst movies of 2017 list. 3 out of 10.
Whoa! 3
3 out of 10. Stop, Michael Bay. We paid you enough
and
ransom money.
And one movie will earn 2 spots on the worst list of movies of all time.
For me,
JP Sebastian.
Not all times this year.
Thank you so much for being with us. Don't worry, we're going to make you a cup of coffee. It's going to be fine. Team, over to you. Of course, if you want to see all of this, of course, you can catch Transformers The Last Night at your nearest new Metro Cinema this weekend. It got a 3 out of 10. Go see it.
Find the best entertainment at new Metro Cinemas. It's your scene.
Calm down, JP. Calm down. Anyway, listen, going to the movies is nice.
Yeah.
Going to the movies and having popcorn is rather nice. Going to the movies, having popcorn and your favorite cool drink is quite nice. But it could be even more exciting if you go and watch a movie at one of the most exciting cities in the world.
Oh, definitely. And with some of the stars of that film. And now, thanks to the new Metro Expresso Movie Club, you can do just that with our latest giveaway. Take a look.
Win a jet-setting movie experience with New Metro and Expresso. One lucky person and their partner will enjoy flights to New York and accommodation in Manhattan to attend a fan screening of the action-packed new film, War for the Planet of the Apes, attended by 3 of the main cast members. To enter, SMS the keyword New York and your name to 40675 by the 22nd of June. Winners must have a valid South African passport, and all the T's and C's can be found at expressoshow.com.
Well, we're taking a quick break on your Feel Good Breakfast Show, and I think the one person with the sweetest tooth in the studio is Gabby Esposito. She's going to show us how to make molten caramel lava cakes. Ooh, you do not want to miss out on that recipe. And then, of course, we also have another performance coming your way from Questa. That and a whole lot more on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Struggle with commitment? Before trying anywhere else, book on Travel Start. We will turn your guilt trips into good trips. Book flights from 499 Rand, only on travelstart.co.za.
To your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's Expresso on SABC3. Time for us to take a look at what our international stars are up to.
Well, I love these girls because they gave us the definition of what a scrub is. We didn't know before, you know, and we don't want them. We don't want them. So we weren't ready for this one. We've all been wanting more music from TLC ever since we got addicted to scrubs. And now it seems that our wish is finally coming true. Why? Because TLC has announced that they won't just be making new songs, but they're going to be making a complete new album, which will drop later this month, y'all, their first in 15 years, hallelujah. Now, it gets even better. The group's member, Tion T-Bars Watkins and Rosanda Chilli Thomas, have also revealed that the late bandmate, Lisa Left Eye Lopez, will also feature, thanks to past interviews and unused vocals.
Oh, wow.
So I think everybody will be singing, you know, I don't want no scrub. Hey. Scrub is a guy that can't get no love from me. I sing that all the time.
You got to finish it, though.
Times like that, I'm going to have to go
the passenger
the
side of best friends, right? Try to holler at me. Yeah, you can't just leave it hanging there.
I apologize.
You know what I mean? Can't wait for it. Graham, how are you feeling about that?
Absolutely love it. But now I want to take cognizance of the fact that, unbelievably, it has been a year since the tragic loss of Gugu Zulu. And tonight, on Top Billing, we have an inspirational memorial as we visit Letshego and Lelethu Zulu, of course, his wife and daughter, to reconnect with him a year after this tragic loss, not only to the world of motorsport, but to South Africa at large. And that's tonight at 8:30 with the repeat going out at 1 p.m.
Join us tonight on Top Billing and meet South Africa's award-winning drumming act, First Project, who've performed in 25 countries around the globe.
It's not easy making it in the music industry, but I can guarantee you that with talent, hard work, perseverance, and dedication, anything is possible. Meet First Project, a group of drummers who describe their sound as aggressive percussion.
Jade takes off on a magnificent trail ride with expert guide and world champion triathlon contender Bradley Weiss.
Just an hour from Cape Town, nestled in the Hottentots Holland mountain range, is the town of Grabo. Pro triathlete Bradley Weiss is here to show us around and take us on an adventure.
We invite you into a beautiful Georgian home in Joburg, renovated by designer Buzwe Mabuza and architect Africa Mbata.
Let's talk about the style of the home. I see a lot of different influences.
This is actually a combination of what the husband and the wife like, which are two different things. The husband likes the style very modern, very clean with clean lines. The wife likes it more classical. So what we ended up with is a fusion of French provincial, classical, Afrocentric, and modern elements in it.
Jade steps into the ring with actress Nicole Besick for a charity boxing match with an anti-bullying message.
I've watched the celebrity fights for the past few years, and I've watched Jonathan Boyton Lee do it, Sivan Gezi, Jack Parrow, Ryan Werther. So when Bruce, the organizer, phoned me and asked me if I'd like to be a part of the first female celebrity fight on the continent, I couldn't resist the urge.
With the help of her loving family and a return to her fitness work, a year after the tragic loss of her husband, Gugu Zulu, Letshego Zulu is back in action.
Letshego's got me here on the rooftop, sweating like a mad person.
Why are you sweating? You need to work on your fitness.
Clearly I do. Health and fitness guru extraordinaire, this Thursday on Top Billing SABC3.
That's tonight at 8:30. Repeat Sunday at 1 on SABC3. The stage is yours.
All right, we're in the kitchen right about now. And listen, we do know that winter blues are a real thing. That feeling of not wanting to get out of bed in the morning. It's cold. You don't want to go outside. But we're going to make a recipe right now for you that's going to encourage you to go to the shops right now, get the ingredients, make it, and then go back to bed and eat it. Of course, we've got Gabriella Esposito.
Quiero respirar, quiero despacito. I'm loving this. I really am.
Hey, listen, it's your new intro now.
It is.
It's like we've got a little...
That's so great.
Lingo. Listen, how do we make this? What is it called? You want to call it
a molten lava cakes, caramel. Lava cake. We'll add that in there.
It sounds absolutely delicious.
It's almost like a chocolate fondant, except we're making a caramel, and molten just sounds like oozingness everywhere.
Can we take a look at what it looks like inside?
You're welcome.
If I cut one of these ones,
that's a bit stressful. It's always thinking you don't know if they're actually going to be molting.
Come
inside. It should be.
Be molten for us.
If it isn't, I'm so sorry. But then you must just cook them for less time.
Look at that. Yes. Okay. Well, look, it's molten on the inside. You've got to use your imagination a bit.
It's cooled down.
It
has been sitting.
So it's like it's formed a rock. Yeah. Okay.
Sounds appetizing. Okay.
Go ahead and show us how to make it.
So you've got your two eggs here. Mm. And then we're going to add is just two extra egg yolks.
Okay.
Just for the extra fat.
Alrighty.
And we've got some vanilla. Yeah, do you want to just keep whisking out there? Thanks. And you got some vanilla, and you should just whisk that up.
Vanilla is like the magic of all things baking. Moment you put vanilla into a set of ingredients, you get the sense that, or the smell that, now
exactly.
We're baking.
And what we've got here is just, get some, you either can make your own caramel or just get the store-bought tin of caramel.
Yes.
That we're gonna add in there.
Now, when you are whisking, would you apply the kind of aeration technique to, if you want to make your molten cakes?
Yeah, you kind of want it, because we only put a little bit of flour that we gently fold in afterwards. You kind of want it to have a bit of air. So either you can do this by hand, or you can have a beater that can help you out at home.
I find it's better to get involved. Really,
but I mean, if you're happy there, then that's so fine.
So about that consistency there?
Yeah, so I mean, it's usually about like 4 minutes, but I mean, this is looking good. You basically want it to be kind of like a thick and a pale consistency. So color's looking good,
yes.
But it's fine, because all
pretty much what you do is me fold in our flour and we're done.
Okay, so how do you...
So that's looking good.
Goodness.
That's looking good.
Listen, you at home can SMS the keyword cake to 33728 and we'll send you the ingredients so you can make your own caramel molten lava cakes, ideal for this winter season. It's like, we say now, it's so difficult to eat healthy.
It's so hard.
Because your body's just saying, give me comfort food.
Like, so this is just one of those. Who wants to eat a salad? And no, it's just not gonna happen. It's not gonna happen.
We try. So you fold your flour in.
So you fold your flour in just to kind of keep that aeration that you just so nicely did now with whisking it up. Mm-hmm. And then all we're gonna do is we've got something called dariole mold, which you can get at any baking store and they're not expensive. If you're at home and you don't have them, you can use a ramekin, which is lightly greased, so just these have like a nice little shape. That's why we use those. Mm-hmm. So all you do is you fold this in quite nicely, mm-hmm. and then all we're gonna do is we've got these greased, and we're just gonna simply put our mixture in.
Okay.
About halfway up.
Yeah. So my mixture has a couple of clumps in it.
Yes.
Or lumps and clumps, but that does it matter?
No, it kind of melts into it. So as long as your flour is sifted and there's not like massive clumps, then you're like kind of fine.
Let's quickly drizzle some of that beautiful melted caramel.
Oh, well, that's actually more for decoration afterwards.
Yes.
So you basically bake them for about 12 to 15 minutes. Mm-hmm. Obviously, the less time, you'll have more the oozing effect.
All right.
And we're going to top it up with some ice cream because we can.
Go right ahead.
So a little scoop of ice cream.
Oh yes, Mount Delicious.
And then we're gonna drizzle with a little bit of melted caramel that you're gonna have left over.
One more time, SMS the keyword cake to 33728 and we'll send you the link to the recipe and the ingredients list. May I taste this one?
Please do.
Oh my goodness.
So another sneaky trick is if you're making this for your guests and sometimes like this happens, if they overbake for that extra minute and it doesn't have that molten feeling, simply just cut a little hole at the bottom, put in some extra melted, and then put them on a plate. They wouldn't know.
Simple
they wouldn't
as
know.
That.
So that's what you can do if they turn out like this and they don't always have that molten center, mm-hmm. you can fake it.
Alrighty.
No one's gonna know.
So cake to 33728. How delicious is that good?
Absolutely beautiful stuff. Now this morning we're going to give you the opportunity to have your cake and eat it. Yes, hot off the heels of the opening of their fifth 4DX cinema in South Africa. New Metro brings you Transformers the last night on the same day as its global release. It gets even better though because now you can experience the film in 4DX cinemas nationwide as part of the latest Expresso New Metro Club giveaway. So New Metro's 4DX cinemas, they offer 3D visuals along with Dolby 7.1 surround sound enhanced with effects like wind, water, scents, moving seats, lighting effects, and loads more, which is going to leave you feeling like a Transformer this morning. And now you can catch it at the V&A Waterfront, the Pavilion in Durbs, Menden Park in Pretoria, Hyde Park in Josie, and of course, the newly opened Emperor's Palace Cinema. Stand a chance of winning by simply SMSing the keyword night, your name and city, to 40675, and you could be a winner today. Remember, you need to add the city in which you're able to watch the screening as well. With humans, Transformers, now at war, Optimus Prime gone and lives on the line. Will this be the end of the world as we know it? Well, you better enter to stand a chance of winning to find out.
Find the best entertainment at New Metro Cinemas. It's your scene.
Oh, well, listen, it's your Feel Good Breakfast show. We're going to take a quick break. We've had one awesome performance already. Don't miss another one from Questa after the break.
And then we also take a look at Africa's biggest animal relocation project. All that more coming up on your Feel Good Breakfast show.
welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Thank you for choosing in to start your Thursday morning off with us.
We're going to give you your just rewards right now with another performance from the king himself. It's Cuesta.
So pretty much everywhere you go, you'll hear couples confessing their undying love, or some of them trying to get back in that love with the song playing smooth and softly in the background. It's another masterpiece by Cuesta featuring Tubbsy called Ngiyasifela Ngawe.
Issue.
When I was tarnished for that, I would die another day just to bond with you. I appreciate the life that we share together, but I love you for the life we brought here together. I love you through the distance, the I love you texts, the kisses, and I love the sex. But it hurts when the rumors come out, you took who and who out, and I'm just human to doubt, man. I wanna stay, I should take this right. Look, I love you, but I hate this life. It's your so much, I hate it. I hate the fact that I gotta say this. I hate that all you see is girls naked. I hate the fact that you don't choose to see the hatred. Look, don't get me wrong, I don't hate you. I hate how you hate how I make what you hate, boo. I hate leaving you alone. I hate that of late we've been speaking through the phone. But that's what it takes to stay afloat, real talk. That's what it takes to raise a daughter, real talk. Now I'ma love you from this life to the next. But I swear I hate this life that you've accepted. I hate how this thing happens. I hate how I'm making it and we haven't. How you believe every basic shit. Look, I love you, but I hate this shit.
Yes, we're not. I'm saying I want a mantra. Oh,
ngiyazivela mina
angisena ona amandla
ayibo
okuyekelela okusala ngiyokuyathanda
yesu ngiyazivela
Thank you.
Oh man, too hard, my lady. Amazing, amazing quest. Do you guys take responsibility for the many relationships that you've saved as a result of this song? Just putting it out there.
Well, I don't know. If there's facts behind it, and you know, it is what it is.
How did this magic happen? How did this magic happen?
It was in studio stuff. None of it was pre-planned. It was literally
fate.
Yeah, it was literally just fate. We didn't come
the stars
there.
Stars aligned.
Yeah, just literally. Yeah, we're in studio trying to do something. Yeah,
I'm trying to do something.
That's what came up.
Well, I'm hoping there's more of that to come, man.
Definitely.
Really, really loving the song. Hope you enjoyed it too at home. Let us know what you thought about that live performance of Ngiyazivela Ngawe on our Expresso Morning Show SABC3 Facebook page.
Oh, God. Thank you.
En die nasionale minister van energiesake, Mamaloko Kubayi, sê die regering sal as deel van sy reaksie op die resessie sy kernkragplanne hersien. Kubayi, wat in Moskou is vir die Atom Expo kernkragkonferensie en ook aan die hoof staan van 'n afvaardiging uit Suid-Afrika, sê hy beskou kernkrag as deel van 'n diverse potpourri wat hernubare hulpbronne en steenkool insluit. Ondertussen het die departement van energiesake bevestig dat Kubayi met die hoof van Rusland se staatkernkragprogram Rosatom ooreengekom het dat die Russe se tegniese spanne die besprekings oor samewerking aan die gang sal sit. Reavaya en Metrobus se reisgeldverhoging goedgekeur, of liewer die stad Johannesburg het bekend gemaak dat pendelaars wat van Reavaya en Metrobus dienste gebruik maak van 1 Julie af meer vir hulle reise sal betaal. Die stad se burgemeester komitee belas met vervoer het 'n verhoging van 6% vir Reavaya en 6.2% vir Metrobus vir die 2017-2018 finansiële jaar goedgekeur. Die stad Kaapstad het ook vervoer vir Julie in die lig daarvan dat 'n besteding van 6.8 biljoen rand vir opgradering van openbare vervoer in die vooruitsig gestel word wat onder meer 'n nuwe spoorlyn, 'n nuwe My City roete vir die metro se suidoostelike gebied en paddeurgange insluit. Op die internasionale front koning vervang of liewer die koning van Saudi-Arabië het sy seun Mohammed bin Salman van as kroonprins van die in die plek van sy neef Mohammed bin Nayef aangestel. Koning Salman se dekreet kom daarop neer dat prins Mohammed bin Salman nou adjunkt eerste minister word en steeds voortgaan om 'n minister van verdediging te dien. Ondertussen is prins Mohammed bin Nayef ook sy amp as hoof van huishoudelike veiligheid kwyt. Hy het trou aan die nuwe kroonprins wat sy jonger neef is gesweer. En dan ten slotte koningin Elizabeth II van Brittanje het in die hoorhuis van parlementêre openingstoespraak gelewer waarin 'n menigte voorgestelde nuwe wette om die Verenigde Koninkryk vir 'n ordelike uittrede uit die EU voor te berei bekend gemaak is. Groot fokus is in die koningin se toespraak geplaas op Brexit en die stryd teen terrorisme. Maar sy het geen melding gemaak van president Donald Trump van die VSA se staatsbesoek nie. Ondertussen is haar eggenoot, die 96-jarige prins Philip, weens 'n infeksie in die hospitaal opgeneem en het gevolglik die amptelike opening van die parlement misgeloop. Well, that was your 8 o'clock news update. Let's get another look at what's happening in the world of sport.
Morning. Clearly, the Pro Tiers battling to make the transition to the shorter format of the game, slumping to a 9-wicket loss against England last night in the first T20 game of their three-match series. Batting first, South Africa made it to 142 for three, thanks to a 110-run fourth-wicket stand, record stand at that between Farhan Bahadin and captain AB de Villiers. And in reply, England easily chasing down the winning target with five overs remaining. Match two of the series taking place tomorrow at the County Ground from 6 o'clock SA time. Then on to continental football. Mamelodi Sundowns earned a point in the CAF Champions League last night after they played out to a goalless draw with Tunisian side Esperance. The result sees Sundowns move up one place to second spot in Group C with 5 points from their four games played. Elsewhere in the CAF Champions League last night, Zanaco beat Cotton Sport 1-0. Al Ahly, they suffered a 2-0 loss to Wydad AC, whilst Al Ahly Tripoli, they saw a 4-2 win over Caps United. Then staying with the beautiful game, Portugal earned their first victory at the Confederations Cup last night after seeing out a narrow 1-0 win over host Russia in Moscow. A towering header from Portuguese captain Cristiano Ronaldo in the first 10 minutes of the game proved to be the match winner in the end. The night's other fixture saw New Zealand, despite a very strong start, being knocked out of the tournament after a 2-1 loss to Mexico. And tonight's fixture sees Cameroon up against Australia in the second game, Chilli facing a very tough test against World Cup holders Germany. And finally, in tennis, world number 8, Dominic Thiem, was knocked out of the Halle Open yesterday after suffering a straight sets loss to Robin Haas in the second round. After going down 6-3 in the first set, Thiem fought back to force a tiebreak in the second. However, it was Haas who came out on top to progress to the third round. Some other results from the day saw Alexander Zverev beating Philipp Kohlschreiber, while Bernard Tomic, he lost out to Richard Gasquet. That's a wrap of your sport for this morning.
Well, let's take one final look at your traffic on this Thursday morning, starting off in Gauteng and Midrand. On the N1 southbound, there's heavy police presence that's at the Allendale Road exit due to potential metered taxi protests. So you can expect heavy delays all the way from the N14 Brakfontein interchange. In Cape Town and Bellville, there are also some heavy delays on the N1 inbound. That's from Brackenfell all the way heading towards the CBD. The roads are also wet this morning, so please allow for some extra travel time. Extend your following distance and remember to switch on those headlights. That's where we leave your traffic for this morning. But let's take one final look at what you can expect in your weather. And it seems like the northeastern region can experience some sunny conditions. However, rainfall and chilly temperatures can be expected along the garden route. Ons begin met temperature in Polokwane 6:22, Mbombela 11:29, Pretoria 7:22, Johannesburg 4 en styg na 21. Mahikeng 4:24, Klerksdorp 1:24, Kimberley 3 met 'n maksimum van 22. Bloemfontein koel begin met -2 en styg na 21, Richards Bay 16:29, Pietermaritzburg 9:27. Durban today, sunshine can be expected, 16 with a high of 25. Mthatha 6:26, East London a cool 0, reaching a high of 23. Craddock also starting on 0 with a high of 21. Port Elizabeth 9:18, George 8:15, Sutherland minus 5, reaching a cool high of 7. Cape Town 8 with a high of 16, Worcester 0 reaching a high of 12, Springbok 2 15, and in Upington a low of 4 with a high of 22 degrees Celsius. That's where we leave your weather on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
I'm heading to Zanzibar,
the Kingdom of Bhutan,
in Mauritius,
Angola.
I always go back to Italy and Cape Town, of course.
So we're going to take a very quick break. When we return, we're going to head into the wild, as we do on a Thursday morning, and we're going to broach what sounds like an effort fit for Noah's Ark. We are going to be transporting 6,000, and I say we, we're going to broach the team that are going to be doing that, 6,000 wild animals across country. It is going to be an unbelievable feat. We'll get the details.
And then we focus our attention on a very unique project, in fact, one that is helping to empower women to take care of the bare necessities. Love Stay it. Tuned. We'll be right back.
I'm a dreamer, a doer.
I know the hustle.
I just need my money to hustle for me.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back. You're live with Expresso. Your timing is perfect as we head into the wild for what sounds like a groundbreaking initiative. Now, in a move similar to Noah and his Ark, the Peace Park Foundation has set out to move more than 7,500 wild animals cross-country in the largest ever wildlife relocation project. So after a near complete wipeout of the wildlife at a national park in Mozambique, in an unprecedented move, more than 7,500 animals, as I've said, are being donated by the Zinave National Park in Mozambique to help replenish the damage done during the civil war. Now with us today is Werner Myburgh, CEO of the Peace Park Foundation, who are spearheading this project. The foundation has done some unbelievable things, from supplying fresh water and food to communities without, obviously, and to their work with the national parks and rhino orphan care. You guys cast a very wide net. You connect with a lot of key role players in the wildlife space. This, I would have to imagine, is kind of a coming of age for you guys. So congratulations.
Thank you, Graham.
How are we doing this? 7,500 animals across quite a vast distance. How is this project being brought together?
Well, I think, first of all, you have to have somebody that pays for it.
Yeah, I'm glad you raised that. Yeah.
And it's quite expensive. This exercise is about $2.5 million, just to move them. And what's fantastic about this initiative is that a gentleman with the name of Willy Papst is a private ranch owner in Zimbabwe, are donating about 6,000 animals of the 7.5 that we're moving. So as his contribution to nature and conservation, and as you rightly stated, this park in Mozambique, Zinave, I've been there quite a couple of times. We've signed an agreement with the government to jointly manage the park now, but it's completely devoid of any life, really. So it's very sad to see this, and this is really a rewilding initiative, and that's why we need so many animals to really build up nature from scratch.
An entire ecosystem, by the sounds of it. Yeah. I'm glad you mentioned the partnership in terms of curating and looking after this particular area, because that in itself is going to be a massive undertaking.
Very much so. I mean, I think that your first and foremost interest will be to look after the safety of the animals once they're there. And that's one of our primary roles as Peace Parks Foundation, is to support the government officials in the park to train more people. So we're immediately employing 30 more rangers.
Wow.
And these animals are all being moved into a fenced-off area. So we're not releasing them into a 400,000 square kilometre park. We're moving them into a 18,000-hectare fenced-off area. And it's a phased approach. I mean, you can imagine, Kruger Park's 110 years old.
Yeah.
So it's not quick. It takes quite a lot of time. So the first phase is to get them there, to make sure that they're safe, and gradually release them into the larger park.
Now, yeah, I mentioned Noah's Ark, you know, animals came two by two. One thing that really interests me here is that, you know, how do you go about selecting the animals to create that balance? Do they come in pairs? Do you look for mated pairs already? How do you even begin to select animals on this scale of move?
Yeah. Well, what you do is the animals are being captured, rounded up by helicopter, and they chase into a funnel and then eventually into a boma and then loaded onto the trucks. So when they with helicopter, scout for which animals you want to capture, so we're capturing basically everything, you take the family structure as is. So Impala will have one ram with 30 ewes, whilst kudus will be maybe, you know, one bull with 6 or 7 cows. So it's not, you know, like a Noah's Ark, really. You use the structure of the family groups.
You're taking the communities
and you take a whole family, yeah.
I absolutely love that. Well, congratulations on your efforts, Werner. I know the journey has yet to actually begin, but I'm sure you've already walked some pretty hard yards. So well done to you and your team, and all the best of luck. We're going to be watching this very closely, and we want as many visuals as we possibly can. But a real feather in your cap. Congratulations.
Thank you, Graham. Much appreciated.
Awesome stuff. We're going to continue our wildlife chat. We've got more guests joining us on the couch. If you've got any questions, any cool stories you want to relate to us, give us a call, 021-430-9881. We're going to head back into the wild in a moment.
I think most of us have fond memories, like I do, of the time when my grandmother used to like knit winter jerseys for me. There's something just about a handcrafted item that carries a lot of love and care from the artist who created it, isn't
it? That's true. Yeah. Well, at Rare Bears, a simple crochet needle and wool is used to create an exquisite stuffed animal, which brings hope into the life of its maker as well as the children across South Africa.
Ngijabulela ukrosha nokufunda amazebra nokufunda amagiraffe yonke into ngangiyifunda.
In March 2015, the Rare Bears project began with just 9 ladies who would learn how to crochet, and Nozipho Mbatha was one of those original 9.
Ma ufika la nesikhathi siqala ukufika la bengakwazi ukrosha. Upinkwa khona ukungifundisa ukrosha.
Rare Bears is a group of ladies who crochet unique soft animals, which is purchased by Rare Diseases South Africa and distributed to pediatric patients.
On our second birthday, Rare Disease SA decided that we needed to commission some teddy bears to our pediatric patients. Most of our patients suffer from very rare diseases that are life-threatening. Most of them are children and won't even make it to their 5th birthday. So we wanted just to give them a little something special to help them through their journey. When we started the program, they couldn't crochet. We worked with Bryanston Bible Church, and together we taught them how to crochet. We now have 54 full-time employed ladies that can crochet almost any animal.
Most of the women who crochet these animals are the breadwinners of their household, and the soft toys are their way to earn an income and provide for their children.
My favorite animal rabbit to make is a zebra. I like the colors like black and white. It's so attractive, and that's my totem.
My favorite rabbit is elephant, because I like the color gray, and it's easy for me to make it. I can make 2 or 3 in a day.
I've benefited a lot. As a single mother, I can now pay my rent, because it's like I'm working. I get salary each and every month. I can now pay my rent and put the food on table for my children.
We show the ladies a prototype. The ladies then go off, they go buy their own wool, they go buy their own stuffing, they go buy little eyes for the rare bears. They all get together, they prepare the bear. We then come back and we critique it. And basically it goes through a quality survey process, and as soon as we're happy with it, we sell it.
The soft animals can be bought by the clinic and donated to a child with a rare disease, or they can be purchased as a personal item and make for a great gift.
The project has grown tremendously over the last few years. We've really touched the lives of over 5,000 families. We're really making a massive difference to people in need, especially little children that are suffering from a rare disease. And we're helping the community. You know, even though we are an NPO ourselves, we believe in giving back. And 54 ladies are now employed full-time. In that said, we still require support from communities, from organizations to sustain the project. We sell the rare bears through our online store. That is www.rarediseases.co.za, where you can either purchase the bear for yourself or you can purchase it for somebody else in need.
Truly wonderful initiative. Now we're going to get back to another awe-inspiring initiative. We broached the idea of 7,500 animals being transported to a brand new home. This obviously involves incredible logistics, yes, but when you get to the safety of those animals, an entirely different dynamic. And we're now joined by Stephanie DeCook from My Wildlife SA to chat about the necessary safety measures to consider on a project of this magnitude. Says Afrikaans, say sal in Afrikaans praat, ek in Engels, ons sal in die middel ontmoet. That's the best Afrikaans I can deliver. I always get a lot of laughs from studio, but this is something that blows my mind, but it also makes me nervous. Yes. 7,500 animals. I would imagine stressful for the humans, but also very stressful for the animals. How do you go about dealing with the safety of the animals in this instance?
Kijk, Graeme, jy moet onthou, as jy met professionele mense werk en hulle weet wat hulle doen, dan gaan jy nie somme moeilikheid kry wat die diere aan betref nie. Daar sal altyd stresvlak wees in die diere. Ons werk met hulle diere. maar ons het altyd 'n veearts by ons in die vangspan. Sodra die diere gevang word, hulle word op die trokke gejaag, dan word hulle dadelik gekalmeer. So dit is
You've done it before, and you've obviously this is a tried and tested technique. It's just being done on an entirely different scale. What makes you nervous about doing something? We're talking about 7,500 animals. What are the things that send off alarm bells for you?
Dit klink verskriklik baie, maar dit gaan oor 'n lang tydperk gebeur. Jy weet, ons werk met 'n goeie vangspan, Patamacha. Ons vang 1,000 bokke 'n week. Dit is 'n average vangs. So as jy 7000 bokke oor kom ons sê 3 maande of 'n jaar of 3 het hulle gesê vang, is dit klink na 'n groot projek. Dit is 'n groot projek, maar dit is standaard wildvangs. So dit is maar net
Yeah, it's just applying what you do and I love the fact that we are reintroducing an entire ecosystem to an area that has been left barren through the most tragic loss of life, human life, yes, we know within that area in Mozambique, but you know, you don't think about the knock-on effect for the animals in a war-torn area.
Ja, kyk, hulle skuif daarom net 600 kilos. Ons skuif wild tot en met Namibia 1800 kilos. As hulle se dit het is, kan hulle dit hanteer. Jy moet net mooi met hulle werk, jou veearts moet op standby wees en jy werk met professionele vangspanne.
So you've done this many times before. Have things gone wrong for you in the past? What's one of the scariest things that's happened to you during a move like this?
Well, ons het so rukkie terug 'n goeie trop van 50 buffels gewerk. Jy weet, hulle raak me aggressief as die mense die hele tyd in die kamp rond beweeg en hulle charge die bakkies so. Dit is maar deel van die game en renosterwerk is altyd interessant, jy weet. Hulle word ingeloop in die trailer, hulle is lewend, hulle is wakker as jy met hulle werk, so te sê. En nee, ek kan vir jou sê, dit is 'n briljante bedryf om in te wees en ons geniet dit elke dag.
I can see how proud all of you are. Are we going to be moving rhino and elephants? I wanted to ask. Are you
going
to see big game
moving elephants, like ek dink is by die 50. Ek is nog nie baie betrokke gewees by olifantskuiwe nie, alhoewel ek weet dit is nie klagransie wat die vangs doen en hulle is baie professioneel, so hy sal dit goed kan hanteer.
How close are you going to stay to the project once you've done the move? Do you have to then move on to the next big move, or are you going to be able to kind of see the fruits of your labor and go and visit the park?
Ja, kyk, ons is nie so intensief betrokke nie. Ek is maar net hier vir die wildvervoer deel om net bietjie vir julle te verduidelik hoe dit werk, maar ek sal verseker wil wie meer weet en bietjie gaan kyk wat daar gebeur het na die tyd, so.
It just makes me so proud to be South African to see that Southern Africa is now working together in this way. Do you think this is the future of wildlife? Are we going to be able to get it right to be able to protect our animal in this area?
Verseker, kyk, solank wilde diere 'n waarde het, gaan hulle altyd gekonserveer word. So jy weet, daar's baie greenies wat teen die jagbedryf is. Ek moet sê, as dit nie vir ons jagters was nie, gaan ons sukkel. Ons moet altyd terugkom na die jagbedryf toe.
Oh, thank you so much for your involvement today and
thank
for doing the kind of work that you do. Ik weet jy was 'n bietjie senuweeagtig, but wel gedaan. That was absolutely awesome. So you can of course weigh in on the conversation if you've got any questions. We've got one more segment as we head into the wild. Again, that number is 021-430-9881.
Thank you so much, G. From going into wild to going into the things that concern our pets. We are talking about advice for pet owners today. And if you have one, then stay tuned.
Especially in the art and creative space. And we'll tell you all about the rejuvenation that is happening in our capital city after the break.
Saving on travel is quick and easy with Travel Start. When you book any flight at travelstart.co.za, you will receive a voucher for 50% off your next 2 Uber rides to or from the airport. Simply enter the voucher code in the Uber app when you book your ride at your convenience. It's just another amazing way to enjoy hassle-free, budget-friendly travel when you have Travel Start to take you all the way for half the price with Uber.
Welcome back. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. We have, of course, been heading into the wild as we do on a Thursday morning, but we've been chatting about a modern-day Noah's Ark expedition where 7,500 wild animals are being moved from Zim to Mozambique in a truly inspiring project to repopulate that area. But now we're bringing this conversation out of the wild and back into the home because it's really struck a nerve for me. When we travel, when we relocate, our animals at home, our domestic animals, often have to go through a very similar amount of stress added to by our stress that we suffer when we have to put our animals through stress. And safety for our animals and animal travel services really do focus on this. So please call us with any questions you have relating to transporting your pets, 021-430-9881. And we've got Estelle joining us here. And this really is your game. And you can see how how Bobus is feeling completely relaxed and chilled by you with Bastian there. But it is such a stressful thing to go through. And I always think of the stress that we as humans go through when we're having to put our animals through this. But it is something that can be very stressful for your animal.
Yes, it is definitely stressful for animals, but at the end of the day, the owner has to work with their animals to make the whole process work so much easier. What we try and do is we deliver the container to the owner's home in advance so that the animal can get used to the travel container and make it part of the home environment. And he gets so comfortable inside the container so that by the time that the dog or the cat is ready to travel, the container will be his little
safe place
to go, and that makes it part of the whole process so much easier.
That is incredibly clever, and off camera you would have missed Bob walking in and out of it, so clearly it doesn't stress him out like that. You know, the breeds, difference of breeds, and obviously, I would imagine cats and dogs react quite differently, but how do you approach that, the differences between the animals that you're transporting? Do they all react in a similar way to this kind of mode of transport?
Yes, well, obviously, every animal has to fit into the size of container. This is now a small container suitable for a cat, for instance, that I brought with. Animals have different sizes, so from a Great Dane to a small little hamster have different sizes of containers that we...
Come on, hamsters you hide in your pocket, man. Come on.
But airlines have restrictions, obviously, on different breeds. So there are restricted breeds that are not allowed to travel on certain airlines. These little guys are, for instance, not allowed to travel on certain airlines because of their flat faces, the snub-nosed dogs.
Oh, they battle with
correct. So for a dog like this, we would definitely do a larger container than the average size dog, just to make it more comfortable, more ventilation inside the container to make the whole trip safe and secure.
Where do you guys stand on sedation, on knocking the animals out? Is it something that's recommended or not?
No. Not at all. We feel that the animal should be aware of what's going on around him. The animal has to be used to the travel container, obviously, as I said before. So therefore, if the animal is happy to be inside the container, we always recommend the owner to give a t-shirt or a blanket that the animal knows to go in the container with him. The animal has to be able to drink water. Be able to control their muscles, so that's why sedation is not an option at all.
Might actually just add to that.
Correct. There's quite a few homeopathic products that we use, like calming collars and Calm Ease, which is very good and as effective as a tranquilizer.
You really have educated me this morning, Estelle. Thank you so, so much. I think the proof is in the pudding there. You've put both Bob and Bastian to sleep. They've been de-stressed, and hopefully we've given you a couple of tips there if you're planning what can be quite a stressful move just for the humans, never mind our four-legged friends. But thank you so much to everyone who weighed in on our conversation this morning. Now we're going to turn our attention again to our four-legged friends, but on a different scale now, how to socialize them, which is a vital part of their development.
Now, we all want our dogs to be friendly and trustworthy, especially when it comes to animals and also other people. Dr. Matt's a technical specialist from MSD Animal Health. The makers of Revecto is back to talk to us about how we can go about socializing our dogs. Dr. Matt, lovely to have you. Thank you so much for joining us.
Pleasure.
Socializing, we talk about it. We all heard the term, but it really is something that we should focus on, especially if you're going to get a new dog, introduce it into your household. So I think in a nutshell, how would you describe a socialized dog?
the concept of socializing essentially means that you are exposing your animal to a whole range of different events, animals, environments, etc. And the animal learns as a skill of adapting and coping with changes in the environment. And that teaches that animal to be a much better, well-rounded animal.
Okay, so just a well-rounded animal, you know, that's able to interact with other dogs and other people without problems. So when should you start looking at socializing your dog? Let's say you get a new puppy in the house.
Traditionally, what we do is we socialize pets from 8 to 22 weeks. So most practices and dog schools, training schools, you'll see adverts up saying, bring a dog in from 8 to 22 weeks. Normally, we recommend that these animals are vaccinated and have at least two vaccines under their belt, and preferably something including the kennel cough vaccine as well. So we use the Novivac KC intranasal vaccine. And kennel cough is something that is not only prominent in kennels, but any situation where you have a high number of animals in one location.
Okay. Now the big question here, how do you go about it? What does socializing your dog entail?
I think the easiest route is to speak to your veterinarian. They often have a program happening at their practice, either run by a behaviorist or run by one of their veterinary nurses. Alternatively, you can go to a doggy school, a training school, and then they'll also be able to point you in the right direction.
Okay, but it's really just about getting your dog together with other dogs, you know, that they're not familiar with and start the process there.
Yeah, dogs, people, events. Yeah. Noises, sounds,
all of those,
pretty much anything that they'll encounter in normal life.
All right, perfect. Thank you very much. Importance of socialization when it comes to your pet. So socializing your dog is teaching it how to deal with the world and be more relaxed in unfamiliar situations. So tune in for our next Provecto segment where we will be focusing on the parvovirus. Do I say it correctly? I don't know. Let's find out.
Well, still to come on your Feel Good Breakfast Show, we're talking about an arts revolution that's definitely not to be missed. And then we head to the kitchen where we're making an Asian-inspired dish with green beans. All that and more coming up on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Every pet, you need extraordinary care. Give your dog 12 weeks protection against ticks and fleas in just one tasty treat with Brevecto.
Lucian? Ooh. Lucian?
Yeah, bath.
What happened there?
Bath thing then.
Huh? Okay, so where are we now? 100 and yeah. Lucian?
Yeah, I'm doing the outro with this thing for the projector.
Okay. So is that the first?
Welcome back. This is your Feel Good Breakfast Show Expresso on SABC3. And just before the break, we had an inspiring conversation about how to take care of our pets. And in fact, if you're planning, then why not join the team at Lead Vale Dog Cape Town on Saturday, June, of course, from 12 o'clock until 5 o'clock, again on Sunday, the 25th of June, from 8 o'clock until 1 o'clock, and visit the stand in the park to buy Brevecto products through ePet Store, the online pet store in South Africa, and you'll get a 10% off. For more information, do visit the Brevecto South Africa Facebook page.
For your extraordinary pet, you need extraordinary care. Give your dog 12 weeks protection against ticks and fleas in just one tasty treat with Brevecto.
Well, listen, Pretoria is currently undergoing a rejuvenation, especially in the art and creative space.
Exactly. Well, it's a network of like-minded people who are all getting together in a hands-on kind of project to make sure that they put Pretoria on the arts map.
The Pretoria CBD is filled with great history, but it's also filling up with great art thanks to Capital Collective, a private initiative combining efforts to give the city a cultural boost.
I think the people of Pretoria just decided it's time to put the city on the map. We're tired of everything happening in Johannesburg and Cape Town and Durban, and we just wanted people to take notice of us for a while. We've got a beautiful city, we've got friendly people, and we've got great artists. And so there's a huge art community in this city, for instance. And as you know, art communities are the people who normally drive rejuvenation and new things. So everywhere where artists get together, you know something is happening. The Capital Collective is all about collective action. We're a group of about 8,000 people now in the network of people who are already supporting things and doing things on their own. And it's all about public-private partnerships at the end of the day. So there are fantastic people in the city doing awesome work. Let me go and introduce you.
The collective makes best use of collaborations between both public and private stakeholders, so landmark spaces like the Capitol Theatre can once again become great art hubs.
Hi, I'm Lerato Kuzayo, a multimedia artist based in Pretoria, and I am part of a collective, Capital Arts Revolution, which works in the city to sort of bring arts and revive spaces like this one, which is the Capitol Theatre, built in the 1930s in Pretoria. Well, in spite of its heavy history, Pretoria is a very dynamic space in that a lot of people come through Pretoria when they migrate into the urban spaces, and you still have that kind of vibe with a lot of students who come and study in the city. You have a lot of ambassadors that stay here and diplomats. So it's really a very international kind of world city.
Well, it's amazing. I think there's really been a revival in the Tshwane CBD over the last 3 to 4 years. You know, we've got a regular market that's happening once a month. People are coming out, and especially at 012 Central, we say to people, come out and play in the city. You know, that's what it's all about. We've seen amazing functions, events happening.
The aim of these efforts is to rebrand the inner city and prove that it is indeed livable, resilient, and inclusive. And public art pieces help create conversations around this movement.
Well, I think, Pretoria is known as the sculpture city of South Africa, and it's public art pieces. So we want the public to enjoy the pieces. We want the public to interact with those pieces and to start a conversation. You know, it's all about, what does it actually mean? Do you like it? Is it about urban rejuvenation? Do you want to bring people to see, you know, what, this is what I saw in the heart of town? I mean, it's amazing. And I think, you know, it's sort of a mixture of local art, what we can see, and it's done in a well-thought-out way. So this piece was commissioned by City Property as part of the 2014 Cool Capital Biennial. The sculpture is Johan Norkia. And the rationale behind this, he said, is that it's half human but half jackal. It's called the Mother of Jackal. And it's also similar to what jackals do in nature, to sort of starve itself and to actually reinvent itself. Similarly, the city has done exactly that. And that's why we're very proud of this piece right in front of our head office.
We're very far from the political and the bad background of Pretoria, so we're actually moving forward and it's exciting to see what people are doing and where we're going.
I think the main purpose of art, I mean, if we were to think about it visually, is to add colour, you know, it's to add taste to life. It's the spice of life, really. Artists are always, at the heart, very loving people, and this is how they show the love for the things that they see and they do every day.
Through passion and dedication, the people of Tshwane are uniting in their vision to make the city a great intellectual destination and a place for all.
Absolutely exciting times happening ahead. Now, our next guest, his handmade objects, can be seen as interface between art design, with materials transformed into life products, inspired by design and energy techniques. Now, he's an award-winning designer, and he's collaborated with Africa's best designers. This morning, we're sitting down with Laurie Wild van Heerden and find out what he's been up to lately. How are you, Laurie? Good to have you.
Thank you.
I must tell you, I've seen some of your works and it has blown us away in studio, so it's so awesome to have you here.
I mean, I know a lot of people got to know you for the benches you made. Where did that concept all originate from?
Well, that started about
I would say about 7 to 8 years ago when I was Wim Wurter's apprentice in Komiki, and he was kind enough to lend me his space and studio after hours to experiment with different materials. And I've always had a passion for timber, and for me it's very important to sort of, especially in the bigger beams, to add value and you know, to make a new product from it in a contemporary way. So, you know, the big timber beams were normally used for like cutting, they would sawmill it, or architects or would use it for lintels. But, you know, so I just wanted to sort of emphasize the value of it. And the very first bench I made was actually from reclaimed timber.
Wow.
Found in Stellenbosch.
I love it. Yeah. Where one person just sees a normal piece of wood, you see something completely different.
Yeah.
Now, I know that you've designed everything from stools to side tables. You've incorporated lighting and so many other different things. But what's been your favorite thing to work on?
It's very difficult to say. I've got quite a big range, and I've got a huge passion for collaborating. You know, I find it's a mutual thing, and it's a matter of respect and mutual, you know, of somebody's craft. Even though I specialize a lot in cork and steel, ceramics, I do work with various artists on that, especially Ceramic Matters, who's very good friends of mine.
Nice.
And you know, it's difficult to say what my favorite pieces are. You know, because there's so many things. But there's just, it's endless if you think about it, you know.
The options are endless.
But I mean, yeah, the ceramic range we recently did is awesome. I love the hand painted benches. It's really inspiring, and also my use of cork. You know?
Talking about this, you seem to have a little bit of a cork inspiration right now.
Yeah.
How important a role does the materials play in what you actually design?
Well, the materials sort of, you know, you have to work with the correct materials to design the right product. You have to understand the materials. So essentially, it's the material that makes the main core.
Yeah.
You know, when designing any pieces. For instance, I'm using the cork skulls as a reference here, where it's very difficult to carve that from solid timber, and it takes time. And not just the sustainability factor of cork, because it's actually harvested, and the trees are never milled down.
Yeah.
It's nicer for my carvers to carve it from a solid block of cork. And it also lends itself to its properties, where cork is quite lightweight, you know, and you have to work with curves, you know, and it's also certain grades of cork is outdoor, can be used for outdoors. So essentially with cork, like my large cork pendants and my outdoor birdhouse there, you can use it outdoors, and you can go any scale you want, where steel is obviously heavy. So when I look at steel as a material, I would use it thinner, but because it's strong. So I would use elegant lines, thinner pieces. So materials are everything, to be honest. Yeah.
Well, speaking of those materials, like, do you look at the materials and then come up with something, or do you have a concept in your mind and then decide which materials you're going to use?
Well, it differs, eh? I mean, sometimes you get inspired by a material, or you get inspiration from architecture or wherever. I tend to visit studios a lot of friends, and I love people, you know, so I love visiting their studios, talking to them. And then I find, you know, I just find a way of incorporating the different materials into a design. So for instance, to give an example, I would, for the lineage cabinet, I looked at architecture, Cape Dutch architecture, and I looked at scale. And Lionel Smith, I've always wanted to you know, work with him on a bigger scale, not just the benches. So I envisioned like an heirloom piece in your home where you can have a beautiful painting, and then you look at it, but then yet it's a cabinet that references to our heritage, and he paints mainly Cape Malay women. So it's this very special piece that you know, that lends itself to, again, inspiration and material use and the way things.
That's wonderful.
When you design.
And then I just have to focus on that ceramic table that you designed, which is absolutely incredible. Do you want to tell us more about it?
Yeah, so this was a proper, I would say, I know the word collaboration gets used a lot,
but
I mean, I only collaborate with people I respect and I admire, and that's friends of mine. And Lionel and Ceramic Matters, Gerard and Anthony, they're legends in the trade. I mean, they've been doing ceramics for 30 years. And they develop certain glazes and special techniques. That's their reactive glaze. And Gerard's also got a passion for furniture design. So we spoke about these tables, and we want to do tiles and specialized stuff. So my studio designed the whole structure, the steel inlays, the American walnut feet. It can be dismantled, and it's currently on show at Southern Guild and Silos, the Silo District.
Yeah.
So it was a really cool collaboration, I must say. It's inspiring, and we got really good feedback from it now at an international level, which
that's
is great.
Incredible. You know, very, very cool.
Yeah, I'm happy about that.
Well, Laurie, you are doing so well, and of course, a man who knows how to work with curves. We all love that. Thank you so much for being on the show today. Your work is so inspiring.
Awesome.
Well, his designs are modern and sustainable. South African designer is absolutely taking that flag all the way to the top and doing us oh so proud.
All right, now we all know that green beans are a quintessential winter vegetable, but instead of being boring and just taking and putting it in the next stew or salad, Oscar bora moreki, Oscar bora bana, Oscar bora papa. Let's do something creative with it. Do something zolicious, something zotastic. That's why Zola's here. She's going to be showing us how to make an Asian-inspired green bean dish.
Oh, yes,
my sister, Njanman.
Njanman.
What are we making?
We're making a green bean stir fry, and this is great for vegetarians because the green beans are the star of the show. So no meat added, nothing like that. If you want it to be more colourful, I love green beans just as they are. I like the green, you know, against like a dark background. So I like to just make it with the green beans. But if you want a bit more colour, you could add some peppers, some red peppers, or you know, green peppers and yellow peppers.
This is the unmistakable smell of ikasi on a weekend when there's like a wedding or something going on, and then abomama, they're busy just chopping and peeling
green beans,
just green beans in the air. Do you have a perfect way of trimming them, like getting the ends off as quickly as possible?
Yes, so when you buy them in the packet, they all face the same way.
So
push them all up to the, you know, to the edge, and then just cut
through
the packet, and then they're all done.
And then other side, and then you're done.
But I like the tails.
Oh, okay.
I like the tails. Old people say they get stuck in their throat, but don't worry, they don't. Just chew, just chew. Okay,
all
so
right.
It starts like this. A bit of peanut oil or vegetable oil in a wok, really hot wok. Then we're gonna add some sliced garlic and some chili.
Okay. Just be careful. We know we've had chili episodes.
Yes.
Don't forget about
that,
right?
I mustn't hover
Don't
over
inhale
it, right?
The chili fumes.
Yes. Okay. And these green beans have been blanched, so that's to say that they've been put into boiling water for just like a couple of seconds.
Yeah.
Just so that it takes the rawness out of them. Can you smell the cumin?
Softens the outside.
Softens the outside. Absolutely. Okay.
And of course, these are great. They're packed with vitamins, minerals, and they're a great source of fiber as well. So you want to include that into your diet, right?
Absolutely. Especially in wintertime when you want extra nutrients. Right?
Yes.
Okay, and adding like colour to your
look
food
that,
in winter is fabulous. Okay.
Okay,
so then we're going to make the sauce for it because it's a stir-fried green bean, right? So a bit of soy sauce. Here we go. You could use Indonesian soy sauce, which is extra sweet. Then you don't have to add the sugar.
Hey, easy on the soy. You are soying that thing.
It's going to reduce. Don't worry. And then this is a bit of oyster sauce, or you could use some plum sauce if you like. Okay. See, it's not that much. Look here.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it does.
It comes out really slow. He was really panicked there for a second. Okay.
You at home can SMS the keyword dinner to 33728, and we'll send you the ingredients list as well as a link to the recipe so that you can make your own Asian-inspired green bean stir fry. And
nuts
are like a quintessential part of Asian cooking, isn't it?
Yes, they are, because it's all about texture.
Yes.
All about texture and all about balance. So the saltiness of the soy sauce is counterbalanced by the sweetness of the sugar, and then a bit of crunch and a bit of sort of va-va-voom with the chili. And then this is some sesame oil, okay, for extra flavor as well.
You could have thought of an Asian word.
I don't know any Asian words.
You know, a bit of, you could have said like, you know, a bit of sheshe, you know.
Okay, a bit of that.
Konbanwa, you know.
What's konbanwa?
Konbanwa is what you say when you say good evening in Japanese.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now I know whenever I go to Japan. This is some coconut rice. So it's rice, it's jasmine rice, it's sticky. Cooked in coconut milk, so that it's nice and sticky, and also lots of flavour. Here we go.
Oh my word!
And you know what? Sticky rice is the ideal thing to eat with chopsticks, which is what I learned in China as well. Otherwise, you struggle, hey?
Listen, you at home, SMS dinner to 33728, and as I said, we'll send you the ingredients list as well as a link to the recipe. In fact, let's quickly show you how we made this.
Making a mess.
And then you get some coriander, just layer it on there. Yep. And of course, SMS the keyword dinner to 33728.
Yep.
And we'll send you what you need to make this. And then of course, you just get the ingredients. Get your nuts in the right place.
Sorry.
There we go. There we go. You know what this reminds me of? This reminds me of those Jackie Chan kung fu movies. And then he would go to these restaurants where they would dish up this lavish rice. And then the green bean. I can't pick up the rice. Sorry. I tried. But I've got to go get here.
And it's still that looks crispy. Incredible. Mm. You know what? This afternoon, resident chef Clem Pedro, he's joined in the loft by Janine Wendy Dunnett. Now, Janine sharing her delicious enchilada recipe with the rest of the Afternoon Express crew. Join them later today for some madness in the kitchen. Well, that's where we leave it for now. We'll see you after the break.
If you can't seem to separate the grease or grime from your cookware, it's time to bring in the experts, the Chuck's Heavy Duty Scour Scrubs, to the rescue. Dirt, grime and grease don't stand a chance against this tough scour scrub. Whether the muck's been sitting for longer than you'd like to admit, or pretty much fused into your cookware, then the Chuck's Heavy Duty Scour Scrub is perfect for this cleaning challenge. The unique angled shape is perfect for those difficult to clean areas. Once you're done, give your scrub a good rinse and hang it by your tap with its easy to hang feature. And the cherry on top, the Chuck's Heavy Duty Scour Scrub is machine washable too. Thanks to Chuck's, I now have a clean kitchen and more time to spend on me.
I am no longer relevant, Vantes.
It's my feel good breakfast show.
Welcome back to your feel good breakfast show. It's Expresso right here on SABC 3. Time for a final look at what's happening on social media this morning. Everybody is talking about Belinda Davids as Whitney Houston last night. Manila Von T says, great seeing Mark Lottering and Marlene LaRue at the Artscape for the opening of the Whitney Houston show. Absolutely incredible. Also someone saying they took a lot of pics because they wanted options. Whitney Houston show, okay, that human that broke it down, who she be? She's Belinda Davids, everybody. And then Whitney Houston back from the dead. That's how realistic and amazing it was. And then Clay Mraz saying thank you to everybody that came out. And then I found this one to be really, really nice. People taking loads of videos. Also just saying here, it was amazing to watch Belinda Davids embody Whitney Houston. Go see the hashtag Whitney Houston show running until the 16th of July at the Artscape. And I can highly recommend it. It is absolutely incredible. I did not know we have a talent like that coming right out of our beautiful country. So go and check out more about what people had to say about the Whitney Houston show.
I loved it. Absolutely loved it.
Just look at her social media posts.
Just look at Insta stories. You'll find lots of clips.
Oh, man. I can't believe how much she's like that. So now we know that going to the movies is an exciting experience, but how would you like to see a movie in one of the most exciting cities in the world with the stars of that film? Well, you can with our latest giveaway, thanks to Expresso and New Metro's Movie Club.
Win a jet-setting movie experience with New Metro and Expresso. One lucky person and their partner will enjoy flights to New York and accommodation in Manhattan to attend a fan screening of the action-packed new film, War for the Planet of the Apes, attended by three of the main cast members. To enter, SMS the keyword New York and your name to 40675 by the 22nd of June. Winners must have a valid South African passport, and all the T's and C's can be found at expressoshow.com.
New York. It's up to you, New York, New York. And hold it, Spirit Fingers, and NC.
You better enter, because we are having tons of entries coming through.
Mm. Can't we go as well? Can't they like send us along just to be like the entourage people?
I have a visa. I have a visa. Just
I'll carry your bags.
I have a visa.
I look great in a suit carrying bags. Anyway, guys, we're going to be doing this again, of course, tomorrow. Hopefully you'll join us. And of course, there's lots of feel good.
Yeah, one of our favorites here on the show, Angel Campy, is back for our Friday Funnies.
She is Friday Funny, indeed. Mm. And then we also, it's all about the Tromppoppies, the grote Skier majorettes will be performing on your
That's
show.
Exciting.
We're also heading to the kitchen to make delicious stuff with like cinnamon and oats and rolls and all that jazz.
Well, we know Friday fashion is as well, so we'll take a look at some interesting ways to style your hijab ahead of Eid.
Oh, I love that, man.
What did you guys think of Questa's performance?
So much love, so much gravitas. He's just so cool. He's coming to his own, man.
What's your favorite Questa song?
Good.
I thought you were still trying to think of him. Yeah, but he and Tubbsy with me as Fela Gawa were really, really amazing.
Yeah, amazing.
People at home also enjoyed it quite a lot. And listen, like I said, hopefully you join us tomorrow morning. And of course, keep up to date with us on YouTube. We've got the videos there. We're on social media. Connect with all of us. And of course, at Expresso Show as well. Be safe out there. We love you. Goodbye.
Yay.
Another feel-good production.